There's plenty of space up here. Hello. Good. Yes, right along here. Wonderful, wherever you choose. Hello. Good to see you. Plenty of space at the very front. Hello. Come in. Good to see you. And if you see any rubbish or waste around, I'm here to clean that up. Or any spillages of drinks, let me know, yeah? Any rubbish or spillages, let me know. Plenty of space down the front here, folks. Let's get cozy. Let's get cozy. It's a warm day after all, isn't it? It's a warm day. Everyone got a drink, but we'll stay hydrated with a glass of water or something. Plenty of space over here if you'd like to. Yes, I was just saying, if there's any waste or rubbish, let me know. Or even pick up a newspaper someone left here from the previous show.
Can you believe it?
We have to do everything ourselves here at the Fringe. Oh, there we go. Pack closely together, it helps us stay cool, I've heard. Yes, wonderful. There we go. Make sure the stage is clear of any debris. You can have that. Okay, wonderful. Oh, wait. Oh, the music gets a bit quiet here. If you wait. Oh, it's like we're in a whole different mood. It's like we're going on a musical journey together. Lovely stuff. Right, are we ready to get started?
Yeah,
we're ready to get started. Good, I don't think I need this anymore, so maybe you could just pull that for me. Wonderful. Okay then. Let's switch it from radio to tape. Very excited. Haven't used this before. Okay, let's have a go then, shall we? Hope it works. It's turning. Oh, there it is. Let's get clapping. Oh, yes. Wonderful. Let's get the mood up in here. Oh, wonderful stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this Britische Staatsoper production of La Serva Padrona! Oh, fantastic! Now, I'm afraid, however, I have to start the show with an apology. I'm really sorry to anyone who came to this opera expecting singers or musicians. In this opera, we don't have any of those. No, in fact, due to budget restraints caused by the coronavirus outbreak, the cost of living crisis, and the war in Ukraine, the Britische Staatsoper, formerly known as British Opera, has had to lay off all of its singers, musicians, directors, conductors, set designers, and costume makers. The only person left on staff is me, David Hughes. Thank you. That hasn't happened before. I'm David Hughes, sir, and I am the assistant to the assistant manager.
Okay.
Now, you might be wondering why the Britische Staatsoper, Britain's national opera house, has a German name. Well, we all know that opera companies, like railway companies, are best run when subject to market forces. So, in 1994, alongside British Rail, British Opera was privatised. And just like Britain's railway companies are now owned by and subsidised the state railway companies of other nations, so today, the Britische Staatsoper is owned by and subsidizes the Deutsche Bahn. So, of course, when coronavirus came along, you see, the most profitable thing to do was to fire all of the expensive parts of the operation, the singers, conductors, musicians, and so forth. But they needed someone to be in charge of the building. I was the only person senior enough to be left in charge, and junior enough to be cheap enough not to fire. Now, of course, during the first lockdown, the assistant manager wasn't there to be assisted. So what I ended up doing most of the time was cleaning and maintenance work, hence the overalls and the broom. And one day, I was cleaning out the cellars of the opera house, and down there in the basement, I found this.
Ooh.
This, you may well say, is the emergency opera kit. It was put together in the 1970s, during the Cold War, in case of Soviet attack. But thankfully, it never had to be used. And so I thought, what with a global pandemic, and inflation through the roof, and war in Europe, surely, if any time is an emergency, that time is now. So what I want to do is to use this kit to put on a show, to make music in a crisis, to bring opera back to life, and to save the art form. Are you with me?
Woo!
Oh, fantastic. Now, the opera itself is Pergolesi's La Serva Padrona from 1733. We've just met Uberto, a wealthy man who is absolutely furious with his servant, Serpina, because she hasn't brought him his morning cup of hot chocolate. Now, there's also a butler or valet character called Vespone, but he doesn't seem to say very much, at least at first, so we'll just pop him over here. Now, I have to say, after 40 years or so in storage, don't think the kit's in prime condition. A few pieces have gone missing. In fact, there are only enough super titles for the first song. So I'm going to have to do the rest in English. I hope that's okay. Here we go then, folks. Like I said, the kit's probably a bit damaged, and I haven't had much time to rehearse, so I might need your help as we go along. But let's see what happens as we venture into Pergolesi's La Serva. My God, it's a disgrace. It's been 3 hours I'm waiting, and Serpina, my maid, has not yet brought my cup of chocolate, and I wanted to leave early. Oh, patience, blessed patience. I clearly see my extending to her consideration brings not to me, but constant aggravation. Serpina, Serpina, of a sow, and you are no better. You stand there like you're sleeping, time to wake up now. Tell me, you blockhead, what's happened? Go quickly and find Her Highness. See what detains my precious maid. Please remember, I'm the master. And I, sir, I'm the servant. Must I always be ill-treated? Must I always be defeated? Oh, no, sir. I am here by demanding, with no misunderstanding, the respect you are mistress. Is nothing less than you are mistress. For what reason did I not ask for a cup of chocolate? Well, why the hurry? You dare say why the hurry, when I've been waiting since early morning. And when should I fetch it, dearest master? At once, dear mistress. Oh, no, no, it's too late now, and nearly time to prepare your lunch. And so then, no chocolate for today, sir. We will try to forget it, my handsome master. Please don't be offended. Two characters. One answer. I know. Just do some faces and things. It will be magnificent, I'm sure. Wonderful. There's always trouble when you are near. When she is near, it's high and low, and to and fro, and stop and go. I've had enough now. So don't detect your ways to mend. This is the end. Do you agree with me? Do you agree with me? Should I be crying? No, 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 no. Should I be dying? No, 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 no. Morning, noon, and night, there's trouble when you are near. When she is near, it's high and low, and to and fro. I've had enough now. I've had enough. I've had enough. It's high and low, and to and fro. It's high and low, and to and fro, and stop and go, and yes and no. I've had Wanted to be an opera singer, you see, but it never really worked out. After getting a music degree, I just sort of ended up doing odd jobs and things, and then when the position as assistant to the assistant manager at the Britische Staatsoper came up, I thought to myself, at least then I'll be working with musicians. But I never thought I'd be the one on stage. I thought I'd just be making things happen quietly behind the scenes. But I think it's going okay. Roberto is just a bit of an angry idiot, I think. I'm not sure I like him. But anyway, let's see what Serpina makes of all this.
It all adds up to this then. Though I try to please you, all my efforts seem to be in vain.
Oh, you poor thing, just listen.
And I ask, is it worth it if in return receive the sort of treatment.
Oh, how unfair. Forgive me.
Do not make fun.
Our mistress is unhappy.
And yet, you will regret what you are doing. The reprimand you made was quite uncalled for.
Is that so? You argue like a lawyer.
First you tease me, then wonder why I get angry.
Oh, no, not that, dear. Heavens, no. Please don't get angry. You were very good.
Why must you be so defiant? Why can't you be compliant? Oh, no, shouting will not avail you. Oh, no.
first time.
Forgive me when I'm tender, sir. You wouldn't laugh today without me here, without me by your side. You wouldn't laugh today. You could not live without me.
He couldn't live without me, you know. I do everything for him. I cook, I clean, I cook, and I clean again. And what for? And all he wants is a stupid chocolate.
I must you be so defiant.
Why can't I be compliant?
Oh, no, shouting will often fail you. Oh, no,
pouting will also fail me.
My dear, why cause a riot? Be quiet, quiet. Oh, does that man set me on a seesaw? Set me on a seesaw. Why must you be so defiant? Why can't you be compliant? Studied and studied, and I practiced and practiced. But I never seemed to be good enough, and I never did get to perform an opera. Very sympathetic audience today, I like that. In the end, though, I said to myself, enough is enough. Time to get a real job. And that's when I got the job as assistant to the assistant manager. It was all so exciting at first. Working with the stars of opera every day. But then I began to think, sure, I viewed them as the stars of opera, but what did they think of me? Sure, they liked having a tidy auditorium and sold-out performances and a well-stocked bar, but did they think of the people who actually made those things happen? The administrators, the people who work behind the scenes? Sometimes I wished I could have been more like Serpina and just stand up and say, you could not live without me. Anyway, let's see what happens. Oh, very well. Did you hear her? I must try to be content without my cup of chocolate. I would not dare to disobey our dear mistress. What are you saying?
This morning, this very moment, yes, this instant, help me find a wife. No matter if she's a hag, no matter if she's a shrew, she will do. I'll quickly marry her just to rid myself forever of this witch.
The fool is trapped, he's in a stew. Get married, it's good for you. I approve.
You approve? That's not bad. She approves. With your consent, I'll marry.
Yes, but you'll marry me.
You?
Surely.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Leave me now, my dear girl.
You meant to say, dear bride.
May heaven protect me, or she will be my death.
Oh, you are mistaken. Not death, but life. When I become your wife.
By your dreams and your schemes, I will not be taken.
They betray you, for your lips they might say no.
You've escaped very much so. Too high, was too high, your fancies fly. With my lips and I say no. All the rest is just a guess. Yes. All the rest is just a guess.
Oh, why? You know I am pretty, charming and witty, and very clever. You look a fool.
If I should weaken, she will win.
I think he is relenting, yes, relenting. No, consented.
No, never.
No, consented.
No, never.
Evermore your joy I'll be. Just consent and marry me. Forever.
No, never.
Forever.
No, never.
Wants Uberto to marry her. Suppose that's one way to become the mistress. But will she manage to persuade him? Well, that's the end of Act One. So it's time to have a little drink. And let's have a look in the script to see what's coming up in Act Two. As though in Act Two, Espone actually does something. Let's see. It says here, Espone needs a sword. Let's have a look in the emergency opera kit. I did say that some pieces might have gone missing. There's no sword in there. Does anyone? Wow, now that's an idea. That could make a sword a very intelligent choice. Wonderful. How are we doing this? Perhaps, could you operate the sword for me? I think it's just in the corner. You can stay seated and then, oh yes, just the right amount of reach. Wonderful. So let's do it this way. We'll have a signal. When I waggle my foot at you, could you just poke me and attack me with the sword, okay? Let's just practice that. Maybe a bit faster, but less actually pushing me away from you. Let's try it one more time. Oh, very violent. Oh, wonderful, yes, wonderful. You look like you're actually trying to clean me there, but there we go. Wonderful, I am quite dirty, so there we go. Wonderful, we've got our sword. Let's see what else is coming up in the script. Yes, I prefer the soft end in my direction, actually, but... Okay, now, it says here, Vespone... Maybe we can put it down just for a little bit. It's just rather threatening and might be blocking the view for people behind. Here we go. It says here that Vespone needs to be disguised as a pirate. Let's have a look in the kit. No costumes in there either. Anyone got a pirate hat? Eye patch, maybe? What could we use that as a pirate? As a pirate costume? Maybe if we take this newspaper and just sort of fold it once like that and then again like that. I think that's a pretty good pirate costume. Wonderful. Wonderful. Could you help me out and maybe just operate the spoon, and all you need to do is on the signal, so when I waggle my foot at you, whip the hat off and reveal his true identity. When I waggle my foot. It's a complicated technology. We only have those for special theatre people, those hats, you see. Let's try it one more time. On the foot waggle. Perfect! A round of applause. Wonderful. We've got our sword and our pirate disguise. Good. Let's just make sure we haven't missed anything from the box. There is one last super title left in the box. So we will be able to have a bit more Italian after all. Thank goodness for that. Could you help me out with this one? So you'll have a go, wonderful. Don't show it to anyone yet, but when the time comes, I'll waggle my foot and then just stand up and reveal what's on the card to everyone. But I want it to be a surprise, so just wait for that to happen. Okay, so we're ready with the broom and we're ready with the hat and the super title. They don't happen for a little bit, so you can put them down and relax, and I'll give you a massive amount of fair warning before you need to use them, okay? It's going to be wonderful. Okay, so let's see what happens then in Act 2.
Now that you have agreed, oh, do be careful. We must not fail, Vespore. Act your part with conviction. When I succeed in marrying the master, all that you ask for, I'll give you. I give you my promise. You shall live like a master. Vespore, quickly change and hide over there. When it's time, I'll call you.
May I, my dear maiden? If it's not too much, could I have a cup of chocolate?
Oh, dear sir. For my part, the game is over, and no more will I bore you with my ill-mannered ways.
Heaven be praised.
Will you marry quite soon?
Yes, that is true. But my dear, not to you.
Do as you may. The time has come when I must think of me. I have found me a husband.
Congratulations. And did you find him ready and waiting to be married?
At times the wheel of fate spins fast, dearest master. He is a pilot.
Okay, what's his name?
His name is Captain Tempest, and his name describes his character to perfection. He is not very sociable.
That's bad.
At times he's violent.
That's worse.
And quite uncontrollable.
Heavens no.
And when he is angry, he is fearsome. He takes things and breaks things, he smashes and crushes, and so forth.
But that would grieve me deeply, because I'm very fond of you, dear. Why deny it?
I am grateful, but meanwhile, I wish you the best, sir. God bless you and the maid you marry. But I hope you will think of me sometimes.
Heaven forgive you, dear. Was there need of this sad conclusion, or of this mad confusion?
So foolish.
think Serpina really does love Uberto?
No.
Or does she just want to marry him for his money?
Yeah.
No.
Then again, she is a maid in the 18th century, right? What other options does she have to improve her situation? Maybe she's just making the best available decision out of a bunch of bad choices. She seems kind of in control of Uberto. But in society, right? Not so much. To be honest, I want Serpina to win out. I think Uberto just wants a quiet life anyway, and of course, a cup of hot chocolate. Why not just let Serpina be in charge and share the love and share the wealth? I think he's just being selfish, really. But I wonder if he'll be self-reflective enough to realise that. Oh no, my dear Serpina, you can be sure that I never will forget you.
Would you care to meet the captain?
Yes.
Then I will fetch him now.
Now we shall see her explosive husband. He'll maltreat her and very likely beat her. Surely she needs protection. I will make known my intention. But she's a servant. Why not defy convention? Would I then marry her? Never. No, Miss Holly, never. But these thoughts will not leave me. Not leave me ever. Wait now. I have watched her grow. She is worthwhile, I know. Am I insane? Calmly consider. All these dark clouds remain. But what is this tenderness I feel? Is it pity or love? Ye gods, I start again. Oh, what confusion! What should I do? What should I do? Should I marry her? Should I not marry her? Should I marry her and then divorce her? Should I get a second servant? Should I just have some thousands and thousands and thousands and billions of servants and never do any work myself? I could just marry her and get four or five servants. Maybe I would. So it's such a mess. Such a mess. Oh, what a sorry, sorry mess. A very sorry, sorry mess that gives me gripping distress. There is no use concealing this ever-present feeling. This feeling, it could be just pity, or could be love. Yes, love, but something seems to tell me, to tell me, to tell me, I must. Concealing this ever-present feeling, this feeling, just pity or is love, just pity or love, just pity or love. I must confess, I'm in distress. Oh, what a mess! Oh, what a mess! I must confess, I'm in distress. But something seems tell me, I must think of myself, of Serpina threatens to leave Uberto, and suddenly he loves her. What a cliché! Too classic for words! Who would write such nonsense? Although, come to think of it, it's actually a bit like what happened to me with the Britische Staatsoper. You see, there I was thinking that the stars of opera were ignoring me. And then what happened when Corona hit and they were all fired? Well, that's when the messages started pouring in. Messages of support and encouragement, thanking me for my work and saying what a good thing it was that I was there keeping some hope alive. And that's when I realised I've got it wrong. They weren't ignoring me, and they weren't the enemy. I need them as much as they need me. I mean, I can go around assisting the assistant manager all I want, but without singers and musicians, what good is an opera house? And to be honest, in all this time having to do the maintenance work and the cleaning myself, I've realised that's not easy either, and I'm no good at it, and I need the people with those skills, just like the singers need me, and just like Uberto needs Serpina. And in reality, like we all need each other. And when I realised that, and when I found the emergency operator, that's when I decided to do something. That's when I decided to put on a show, to revive the fortunes of the opera house, to get everyone their jobs back, to bring opera back to life, to save opera! But I must admit, it hasn't always been easy. I mean, I'm just an administrator, really. I'm not a properly trained opera singer, and this tape technology seems to be holding up, but it's not 100% reliable, and this kit has a bit missing. I mean, no super titles, no costumes, and no props. And you know what? This is not even a script. This is a book of songs by Schubert. I mean, Schubert, bloody Schubert. Someone left this in that box 40 years ago and never tied it up. Yeah, Schubert, great. Schubert, leader, songs, Schubert, great. But where's the backing tape? I'm so sorry. It's just a lot of pressure to take. A lot of pressure for an assistant to an assistant. I suppose I've got to realise that tonight I'm the one on stage. And the people that are really important are those who make things happen behind the scenes. And tonight, that's our three wonderful volunteers. So if you're ready with the broom, and if you're ready with the newspaper, and if you're ready with the super title, let's see if we can bring this opera to a happy ending. Here we go.
My dear captain, come in. Oh, Serpina, the captain. Yes, the captain.
Heaven protect her. What a lout. What a type beyond description. My dear sir, lovely to meet you, captain. I hear you desire to marry my Serpina. Oh well, my loss, your gain, sir. Oh well, I wish for you both the best. Oh well. He seems to be a man of very few words. He very rarely speaks.
But imagine what he said.
What, Serpina?
You must give me now my dowry.
Give you your dowry? What dowry? What dowry? What dowry?
Do not shout so. Shouting makes him angry.
And when in anger, he will take things and break things. But not here, do not fear.
Oh dear, now you can see he is quite furious.
Oh, the devil, calm him, please. What will this scoundrel force me to do? What does he want?
The dowry must be £4,000.
What? Just a mere trifle? Only £4,000? Listen, you pirate. Now, hold on, sir. Serpina, do control him. Vespone, where's that blockhead?
But dear master, you are to blame for all this useless trouble.
Come here. This engagement, can it be broken?
Yes or no, it might be broken. Either you give to me here and now £4,000, or he will not marry me.
He said that.
He said that.
And if he does not wed you, what's that to me?
Then you must marry me.
He said that.
He said that, unless you wish to be cut up in pieces.
You said that? Why, how dare you? Wait, don't precipitate. I capitulate. Sir, I will marry her.
Do you swear on your life?
Yes. So all is well.
And all thanks to Vespone.
Oh, you scoundrel. How could you help her to trick me?
Come now, my dear. From now on, no more temper. I am your wife to be, remember.
It's true, and I love you, Serpina.
Ed è veni la serva, Yorcia padrona.
A round of applause for our three.
I ever will be true. And never your love forget. Oh no, my pet, oh no, my pet. And never this step regret. Oh no, my pet, oh no, my pet. The more my pet, my faithful lover ever, my only one forever. Told me music was fleeting. I didn't know it was that fleeting. How am I ever gonna save opera now that the tape is broken? You know, in a funny way, I think maybe we have revived opera theatre now. I know we didn't have an orchestra, or a cast, or props, or costumes. And I know I'm not a real opera singer. By Jove, I think I've finally done it. I think that I have performed an opera. Maybe Veni la Serva, Yoncha, Padrona. And the assistant to the assistant manager has become the prima donna. I'd love to get lovely, wonderful audiences like you. So please tell your friends or leave a review online. If you have any props or anything, please just dump them on the stage on your way out. And also, I found out this is actually the only opera on the Fringe this year. So together, we are genuinely keeping an art form alive. Woo! Thank you very much, and have a good night. Goodbye.